Thank you to the Patreon supporters of the What Remember podcast. Matt J, Jacqueline M, Olin Sandy J, Nathan E, Stephanie O, and Big Time Jim. Tis the season of giving, and what a great time to help support the podcast. And this month, we're putting out a bonus episode, Beverly Hills Ninja. It's a lost episode. The audio is a little funky, but to get that episode and more episodes you can't get on our normal feed, go to patreon.com/whatweremember. Thanks. Welcome to the What We Remember rundown for Star Wars The Mandalorian. This is episode 2, chapter 2, called The Child. My name is Bradley Jones.
My name is Andrew Moldenhauer.
And I'm Andy Hubert.
They finally put a title on the episodes?
They forget on their first one. They were like, oh shit.
Well, wait, isn't the first episode usually just called like the pilot?
This was called
pilot?
Chapter 1.
That's true. They usually do call it just pilot for a lot of series.
Yeah.
They could have called it pilot. It would have been fun.
Yeah, they could have called it The Pilot and have been like, he's that been flying perfect. A ship, man.
That would have made too much sense.
Right? Missed opportunity.
See, so this one was called The Child.
They're talking about Kathleen Kennedy's job is up for grabs, potentially. Hire me. I would have told them that. I'd have been like, name it The Pilot. Boom. Give me a couple mil.
So who's Kathleen Kennedy?
She's
the head of
Star
Lucasfilm.
Wars,
she's the head of Star Wars, basically. Okay.
She's been making movies since the original Star Wars, I think.
80s.
Yeah, she's been involved with it for a long, long time. And, you know, it seems so stupid that there's like reports like, oh, they might be getting her on the outs. And I'm like, yes, the woman who has made billions and billions of dollars. They're like, yes, I'm worried about her performance on Star Wars. Certainly Star Wars has never been less of a relevant thing today, right?
Like, you know, how come they haven't got the $10 billion yet?
When are they going to make another Star Wars, guys? I feel like there just hasn't been enough Star Wars lately.
There's going to be so much Star Wars.
It's
so much Avatar.
Out your ears.
And so many TV shows.
I still refuse to believe that there will ever actually be another Avatar film. I feel like it's going to be the year 2040. We're going to be like, 2 through 9 are still in production. Don't worry about it.
There's a really funny video that Neil Cicerigi does about the Avatar IMDb release date. And it just like fades from release date to release date.
Yes.
And it just like, it's like, it becomes real for a while, and then it gets like so absurd that he just starts like making up dates, like Avatar, like never coming out.
Yep.
I still haven't seen the first one.
Really?
It's on Disney Plus.
Oh, there you go.
It's okay.
I saw that in theaters.
Could watch it with the 3D glasses.
It's the one movie that I actually enjoyed the 3D on.
You're supposed to.
Yeah, and it's like that solidified to me that the only way to enjoy a 3D movie is if it was shot for 3D. Every other 3D movie is stupid and dumb.
Yep, real dumb.
Yep.
Cartoons are good because those can just be made 3D.
Yeah,
and
yeah,
no big deal.
Like, but it doesn't have to be shot away. Yeah, but
I don't know if I've been to a 3D movie.
There aren't many
except for like rides at like Disney World and stuff.
I
don't know if I've ever actually sought out a 3D movie.
I've seen a few.
I think I saw like that Shark Boy and Lava Girl.
That's the red and blue 3D.
Yeah,
it's a little different.
Oh, okay. I thought it was the same thing.
It's
actually.
Red and blue, good, because Shark Boy is blue, and then Lava Girl's red.
Yeah,
it's good.
It's a Lion King last summer in 3D. Speaking of Jon Favreau things,
oh,
and leading into this episode,
right?
It felt very Lion Kingy the way they shot, like
kind of did
low angles. They shot a lot of lizards and things.
They did
a lot of rocks. It felt like Jon Favreau like doubled up Lion King Mandalorian.
Yeah. Man,
the style looked the same.
Yeah, like took two classes in high school and turned in the same paper. That's what it felt like.
How much money did Jon Favreau have?
It felt like
at
the
this
island
point?
And Bad Boys 2.
Yeah.
Yes. Right?
Oh man,
right? Bringing back that controversy.
The same action sequence.
So this episode, if I could use like one big word to describe it. Well, it's not a big
please
word.
Please do. Oh, it's a small, okay. It's just, I got excited. I thought you were going to use a big word.
No, okay. This is big for me.
Okay, there you go.
No, it was cute.
Yeah?
This episode was cute.
Was it cute?
I don't think you've ever said the word cute on the podcast.
It's cute.
Ever, once ever.
It's cute. Are you talking about the scene where he was murdering Jawas? Is that the cute part?
Oh my God.
He was straight up disintegrating.
Yeah, he straight up killed
like three of them.
Yeah.
And I was like, cute.
They're dead.
That's so cute.
Yeah. There's some cute baby Yoda happening.
Oh my God.
This
episode
is 50 years old too.
Establishing Yoda.
It is.
It's his coming out party.
So he is the child.
Yes. Like the golden child. which I know you like a lot.
There you go. I haven't seen that in so long, I don't even think it's good.
You just don't believe it. You're like,
it's good.
I think it's good, but I'm sure it's bad.
It's a really fun movie. It's a big departure from other Eddie Murphy films, I'll tell you what.
That's true. I tell you what. Okay.
The Mandalorian gets ambushed by other bounty hunters.
So those guys look like... It looks like Fifth Element people.
Are they Trandoshans?
Bosk, right?
Yeah, Bosk is one of another famous bounty hunter from the original trilogy. He's one of the ones standing up in the rogues gallery in the one scene.
I had to write down the word Trandoshan, but you just said it just like that.
Come on, son. There's a series of bounty hunter books in the Legends universe now.
Dog the Bounty Hunter
that are
books?
Really good. They follow
R.I.P.
Yeah, no, they follow a couple of the other bounty hunters, and they get into like how the guild works and like they deal with like just being a bounty hunter. It's a really entertaining series. I highly recommend them.
Nope. I don't have time. I barely have time to watch this show. It's only 30 minutes long, Andy.
I watched the show like 8 times already.
You know what? I watched it twice. I watched both episodes twice so far.
You were watching it today, I saw.
On the second viewing, I noticed that in the reflection of the Mandalorian's helmet, when he turns his head, you see them jump across the cliffs.
Yes.
I don't know if you guys saw that at first.
I didn't realize they were the Trandoshans at first, it looked like they were just creatures from the planet that were hopping around above him.
No, they're bounty hunters, you can see them in there.
And then when they jumped down, I was like, oh, it was those? Because I thought they looked like just creatures in the first one. But then they jumped down, they're in suits, and they're just
everyone wants
regular Trandoshans trying to
beat
his crap. Yeah, because these guys were listening in on his conversation with Carl Weathers in the club. They were overhearing. Yeah,
they were in the crub?
In the crub. If you jump back, they're like sneaking and sliming around a little bit in the background there. And you could tell that they're like listening.
And he finds another one of those trackers on them, doesn't he?
He does.
Yeah. Like, I'm wondering too.
People are after this Yoda.
Because they told Mr. Mando, they were like,
hey.
They were like,
you gotta stop calling him that, man.
They were off the record.
Well, Nicky Nolte called him Miss Mando.
How many dudes did he hire for this?
I know,
man?
Right?
Like, did they all have the same thing where they had to like get a card and go to a secret place and
I don't know.
Like Carl Weathers was just messing with the Mandalorian where you're just
well,
like
I figured
no,
that
it's
they,
very exclusive.
I figured they had, I don't know, good hearing. They overheard the conversation.
But they had the tracker though. How
yeah, they
that?
Were hired for sure, dog.
But then the question
they
is
they have to have the tracker. Well,
Werner Herzog is playing.
Then I'm wondering if
each other.
Was Herzog the one that hired them, or are they being hired by someone else who wants the baby Yoda?
I mean, IG-11 wanted that baby Yoda. Who hired him?
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, how does this tracker work? You get the tracker from the guy?
You get the Tamagotchi that has the location of the Yoda.
You gotta clean the poop from your Tamagotchi.
You can't, like have your own tracker and just track it?
I don't know how to change that. That's gonna be something the Mandalorian, like, needs to do.
I'm wondering, they have to, like, show how those work or something, because...
Hack that track.
Yeah.
Ooh.
There should be like commercials for stuff in the Star Wars universe. Hey, you need a hack a track? Call me Jack Attack, the hack a track master. Frack.
I'm still working on it. I'm still working on it.
Yeah.
Not enough billboards and advertisements in the Star Wars universe.
I need to scale back the wordiness to fit on the billboard.
Some of my favorite, like, oh my gosh, some of the best Star Wars stuff is just like making fun of like the idea of Star Wars, but in our regular universe, like the Robot Chicken, where they have like one of those personal injury attorney infomercials, and it's like for a guy who's like, have you or a friend you know been injured by a Jedi? Call me, and I'll sue the Jedis for you. And it's like the dude who got his arm cut off by Luke in the first one, he's just like, he got me $500,000. I was like, this is hilarious. Like, this is exactly the kind of stuff I want to see.
Yeah.
The Mandalorian beats a bunch of these guys up, disintegrates one of them.
Mm-hmm. That's like
about to get
running
to the Yoda.
At Yoda.
Yeah. Because like they want Yoda dead.
I thought they do.
Yeah, see, because that's
IG 11 wanted to kill it.
That's why I don't think that Herzog was the one that hired them, because he was like, if it's dead, as long as you can provide proof of why you that you killed him and that why you had to, that's okay. But the one dude was like, we didn't discuss this at all, and the other guys like IG 11 and these dudes were just like, let's kill this thing,
yeah,
straight up. And so I'm wondering if they were hired by someone else who wants to make sure that Baby Yoda's gone.
Yeah, I think a lot of people want this Baby Yoda gone.
Mm-hmm.
We'll see.
I don't know.
Six more episodes.
We don't even know if this is Yoda.
It's a Yoda.
Well, yeah. Yoda. We just, what, I mean, we like, call it Baby Yoda.
Just, they don't. That literally does not. There's no answer to that question because they've never named his species.
Right. So we're gonna find that stuff out, which is exciting.
I hope so. Maybe we never will. Maybe it'd still be Baby
oh
Yoda.
My God,
at the end
maybe.
Of this. Maybe
like, in Yoda reborn.
Characters in universe start calling it Baby Yoda, and they're like, "Why are you? What?"
Maybe it is Yoda. Maybe he's like reborn. Ooh,
that's yeah, what maybe. That's right. We talked about
he might
that.
Be a phoenix
yeah.
of some
maybe he's
kind.
Like a phoenix.
But then why would he have his own ghost?
That's true. Maybe he can do both. Maybe he's just
double
dipping.
Oh, he's like the 2001 Space Odyssey baby.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He got bored of being a force ghost and was just like, you know what? I'm going to be a baby again. Let's do it.
So talking timeline, the First Order is like on the rise,
I think
maybe?
So. Yeah.
Okay. So Kylo Ren probably hasn't even like been born yet, you think?
I don't know.
He could be a baby.
I think they came out. They showed like an official timeline.
How close is it to Episode 7?
And this series is closer to 7 than it is to 6.
Okay.
So it's. I think it's closer on that. And if I remember.
So there actually
right
might be First
timeline.
Order at this point.
Maybe. Yeah. That could be. They could be kind of like the beginning of.
I was rewatching Episode 7, so it's kind of fresh in my mind. I didn't realize that like they're still called stormtroopers in the First Order, and they're also like raised from children because they just give them like. IDs. You get a couple numbers and a name, and then you just go out there and you're a stormtrooper.
Yeah.
Because Finn is F91928 or whatever.
And then there's TR8
yeah.
OR or whatever. So, 0R traitor.
I'm not sure like how the stormtroopers are related. Like, they're all just stolen as babies and raised
well,
up
well,
in the
it's,
first
that's
order,
an interesting
or,
like set of lore all on its own because the you know you have in the prequels you have the clone troopers
yeah.
and then eventually the idea is like that the Empire didn't want to be reliant on clones and also they just didn't have enough so they just start like conscripting people and actually drafting people to be stormtroopers and now yeah and then in Episode 7 they're like straight up stealing babies and like from like growing them like
yeah.
training them from adolescence
yeah, this is like
to be
a
stormtrooper
or something
like the
it's
Outsiders
the 80s movie
yeah
really
bunch of orphans have to get into a
oh that's true
their
they,
own thing
yeah.
yeah
yeah they create their own little gang
like little rascals
you
is that a better analogy
you gold when you're a kid.
The Mandalorian is beat up pretty bad. He's cut. And we see Baby Yoda go over to him and try to
oh my God, he hopped out of that little
use some force powers.
He hops out of his little egg and he's just like, let me help, man.
Now, correct me if I'm wrong, Andy Hubert. Healing has been mentioned in the Star Wars universe as a possibility, but it has never actually happened. Is this true?
In the cinematic universe, yeah, I don't know if it's even been mentioned in there. It is a thing in some of
Darth
the video
Plagueis,
games.
Darth Plagueis said he could bring back life.
Yes. That's a separate thing, but healing and life and death are not the same.
It feels like kind of the same thing.
Who's yeah. Darth Plagueis? Well, he's the fictional Palpatine,
no, he's,
right?
He's real.
As far as he's a real historical figure in the universe. Yeah. That is who Palpatine tells Anakin about and says, like, wouldn't it be cool if you could prevent death just like Darth Plagueis did? Let's learn
could
those.
Prevent death?
Yeah. Yeah. He had the power to stop death.
You need to rewatch Episode 3.
Oh, God.
That's kind of the whole plot of it.
I told you. The prequels aren't that bad.
I can't.
They're not good, but they're not that bad.
Oh, well, I would agree. I'll agree, but, like, come on.
In the newest Star Wars video game, he uses Stim to heal himself. He doesn't use Force powers, so I don't know what video game that happens
in. The Jedi Academy and Jedi Outcast games... There is definitely, I think there's force healing. We just use some of your force mana essentially to heal yourself in the game. So it's just a convenient mechanic. But
Yoda tries to do it.
Yeah.
But
and the
Mandalorian like,
keeps
get out of here,
like,
dog.
Go back in your egg.
He shuts him down twice.
Twice, and it's so adorable.
It was cute the second time. So he like popped out of nowhere. He's like, I'm back.
He's like, what?
I'm back.
I just want to help. Give me that wound. I want to put my finger in it.
Baby Yoda, you've got some.
All right, we're gonna close
you
in.
Kinks here, Baby Yoda. You're a little young for that. Oh no, you said you're 50. You're fine.
Let me force touch it. Force myself in there.
Oh god, boy.
Baby Yoda,
at 50 years old, you should know consent.
You should know this by now, bud.
But look how cute I am. Just let
me show you. You are very cute.
That's
okay.
So true.
Okay.
Blink my eyes.
So am I, correct me if I'm wrong, some of it's puppetry and some of it was CGI?
It's a mixed match.
It looked pretty good both ends.
It does.
Agreed.
They
do high scans of that puppet.
I tell you, man. Well, it's good looking. I've said numerous times that like I am consistently impressed with ILM's ability to produce the graphics for Star Wars films. Like everything just looks so real at this point. It boggles my mind. The ships themselves look so good.
Anything that's not a person looks really good in
yes,
Star Wars.
That's true.
Universe.
Yes, exactly.
They've got that.
You don't have to worry about that Uncanny Valley area.
That lizard in the beginning looks incredible. I mean, that's like a real lizard. Mm-hmm. But it's CG. It's a fake lizard.
Like when the Jawa's vehicle was moving, there were some like wonky parts here and there. But
yeah. The CG in this episode I thought much better than the other one. But yeah, I don't think they tried any tricky physics stuff in this episode. So you're less likely to run into those issues. But
they're doing weird things with backgrounds now. I was reading an article about how that's like come a real long way. Digitally making like just putting stuff in the background is like easier than ever.
Oh man, well
it's all like fairly new like technology.
There was a great video that I watched that was about that is it Todd Phillips, the guy that directed Joker?
Mm-hmm.
He was showing how in the city that they were shooting in, it just the buildings didn't continue to go back far enough for what he was looking for. He wanted the buildings to like hang over the set. Yeah, he was showing like all of what was fake, and it looked realistic. Yeah. But it was so far into the back that it blended in.
Mm-hmm. Even going back to just like Mad Max Fury Road, like if you watch the VFX layers, I mean, they shot in the desert, but like they just add like essentially a subtle layer over the desert itself to make it like rockier or more vast or much more orange, because that's the whole movie. But yeah, like they're able to just really, it's really effective at layering the VFX on top of practical elements and making them work together really well. And I think that is what part of what lends these new Star Wars properties, I think, to
Force Awakens didn't really have good. It as well. But that movie came out in like 2014 or something 15, like that.
15.
Yeah. And they were specifically talking about how when JJ's next movie comes out, there's going to be stuff in there that they could not have done 5 years ago. It's going to look incredible.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
The technology is moving so fast on that stuff.
Yeah. Isn't there going to be a point where it stops?
No.
Where it can't like get any better?
Uh-uh.
It's going to get to the point where it's like you appear in one movie and then your hologram takes over for you in every other movie after that, you know?
There are stuff in actors' contracts about like digital.
Digital likenesses is going to become like a whole piece of a contract that has to get negotiated about how they can do all that. And I'm sure there's going to be plenty of battles where like estates of deceased actors are going to start fighting.
Oh my God.
People are just going to unscrupulously start
inserting
them. Tom Cruise
is not going to stop acting in movies.
No.
Have you seen some of the deep fakes they're doing now too?
He has CG in his rider to make his body look better. They put like abs on him in the Mummy film. They just do little touches.
That's why he looks good, Andy. Yeah, he's flubby.
Wow. Flubby.
He's flubby.
Tommy boy.
Hashtag everybody out there, tell Tom Cruise he's flubby.
That's a long hashtag.
You're about to get Scientology'd.
Oof. Oh my God.
But Quarter Digital just did a good video where they had a Tom Cruise impersonator come into their studio and then layered a deep fake of Tom Cruise's face over this guy. So the voice and his mannerisms are already there present in the impersonator. And then just adding the deep fake on top makes it like just exactly a real Tom Cruise like came by is what it makes it look like.
If there was a Pierce Brosnan lookalike, it'd be an impersonator.
Ooh.
What you meant to say?
That's good. That's good.
Hey, we're trying to keep it light on this show.
Hey, guys, folks out there.
Let's make a joke. The Mandalorian comes back to his ship looking like, oh, I'm just going to go home. Yep. My job's
done.
Can't
wait to get out of here.
Psych.
Bunch of Jawas. In what's called a steel fortress? What's the name of that
thing? Well, he called it, the steel fortress. It's called a sandcrawler.
They ransacked his ship and took all of the insides out. All of his goody good goods. Mm-hmm. His guns are gone. He tries to start his ship for some reason. I'm like, dog,
bro.
He didn't even have an engine.
I was like, is your suit airtight? Yeah. You're just going to be in space. There's holes everywhere, dude.
He comes back, his ship's on cinder blocks, and he's trying to start it.
Yeah, right. He's like, maybe it'll still work, though.
I don't understand that part. I think there was a missed opportunity there for him to have some sort of like secret compartment that he like checked to make sure something was there, like a photograph.
That could have been cool.
A memento. Like I thought that would have been good. But
I thought this was a good moment though, because it humanized him a little bit. It made me feel that he's like new to this. in a way.
I appreciate
and
it.
I was like,
yeah,
he's kind of an idiot.
That's something I've appreciated a number of times in this series is they show him failing plenty of times so that it isn't just like the perfect fighter warrior guy just destroying everybody all the time. And how cool is that? Like, that's not the show. The show is how does he maintain an image that that is who he is while at the same time, like, figuring out how to do it.
Mm-hmm.
So those have been good.
Those Jawas, though, they know.
Oh, my God.
They know where stuff is, and they're going to find it, and they're going to get it.
Oh, yeah.
Like an ant colony.
Oh, my God. That laugh, too. I'm like,
a piece of gum in your house, and you're just going to find a line of ants towards it. You leave your ship out there. Those Jawas are going to come. I don't even know how, like, do they do interplanetary travel, or are they just living in desert?
That's a good question. Yeah.
Yeah. They just figured it out. But the Mandalorian sees them and tries to, like, run after them and shoot them and, like, fight them on the weird
fortress. Yeah, he kills about three or four of them.
Zaps them, disintegrates.
Well, he's got to disintegrate.
I really like that. Like, his rifle is really neat because it is, like, it's, like, a single-shot thing. Like, he has to, like, a breech-loading rifle.
So I was like, that's not going to help you.
It disintegrates people. Real good.
Yes, but
at the same time, I feel like as a bounty hunter, do you want to disintegrate people? Don't you need like proof that you killed them if you kill them? Like if you disintegrate them, they're gone.
He had multiple guns though.
Yeah, that's true.
He does. Have a shotgun.
He's got he has like a rifle. The same gun can like zap people.
Mm-hmm. Well, he's got the PG gun.
He's got a blaster.
He makes whatever you're looking at a PG rated when he shoots it. Like in a Marvel movie, they don't really like kill anything. They just disintegrate it. Just turn it into dust when it gets shot or destroyed.
Yeah, that's a good point.
I was just watching a video. His blaster is like an actual, like in, this is a very classic Star Wars, but it's a real gun, like a real old revolver, a pretty rare one, under my understanding is that like just has some extra stuff added to it. So like people have been going nuts online about like, oh wow, like super rare gun and like being put into this movie.
He had a whole closet full of sweet weapons.
Yeah.
They're all gone now.
And then people were bringing up that the rifle he has, like with the zap prongs on it and stuff. Apparently, that's actually a throwback to the Christmas special.
Oh,
with like they had like an animated Boba Fett riding a lizard, and he's like purple. Like his color scheme is all over the place, and he has like this goofy looking orange fork that he just like carries, and that's like the rifle in this series.
Interesting.
It's been a nuts.
Interesting.
How about this Yoda egg vehicle thing?
I love it. I want one of those.
Yeah, it's like
it doesn't even have jets or engines. It just hovers.
Well, like somehow it's like tied to him. Yeah, like it just follows him. Like somehow I can't.
It was moving at his pace when he was on the ship trying to like scale it up.
Yep. It was just cruising along behind.
That thing's like trucking. Yeah. Was it going like 30 miles an hour?
It was moving.
Make a human size one of those and look right around in it like Wall-E.
Mm-hmm. He's shot. He finds out his things are getting stolen.
Yep.
He shoots at them. He chases them. They wrap up and they move.
They book it out of there.
Yeah.
They're leaving. And he chases after them and he takes like one shot at like an exhaust pipe or something like that. Was that meant to slow him down?
I think he was trying to like, oh, maybe this will disable their thing. And then it doesn't work, which again, I appreciate.
Yeah, it didn't work.
Another missed opportunity here because he could have like got some sort of mentorship from
Nick Nolte
about like you have to hit something in the right spot to kill it because it would have paid off later in the thing.
Sure.
Is it Nick Nolte or is it Tom Waits or
it's wait. Nick Nolte.
Nick Nolte.
You're right.
Yeah. Cause I don't know. I feel like there's just like
they decided to get the help afterward with that guy.
Yeah, but I feel like there's just always like a little extra tweak or something that could happen to make mean a little more engaged or like set like maybe a little foreshadowing or I always just think there's like it's just too bare bones.
Hmm. Yes, that is how I felt about the series so far. It's kind of empty a little bit.
Give me a lot of time of him
like walking in and just like sandy.
Give me little
areas.
Treats along the way. Give me a little like backstory and building.
It's still probably too early.
That's the hard part for me.
And these episodes are so short.
We're so conditioned to the movies where there is so much packed into like a fairly brief amount of time that like I've had to remind myself numerous times. Like I have to remember this is a story over 8 episodes. I think it is, and it's like a whole arc. And this episode is like five minutes of story
spread out over 30 minutes.
Yeah, and so I'm like,
that's true.
It does feel very empty, but I don't know if that's necessarily indicative of like they just don't have enough in them, or if it's that we're so used to seeing much more. Or in any kind of Star Wars property.
Well, we're also like in parts of this, he's learning how to work with other people, mm-hmm. That's a big part of it. Right?
I was kind of this is jumping ahead a bit, but like he asks Nick Nolte's character, like, "Hey, you want to join my crew?"
Mm-hmm. Right, like, which we were speculating on.
Like, I assumed that would happen, but I felt like it jumped really fast to him being like, "I work alone," to like, "Hey, you want to come with me?" And not that I'm upset, because again, I expect it to happen. It just seemed abrupt almost, but like he never seemed to indicate he wanted anyone to come with him. But
yeah, I think I don't know. I think he's still trying to figure himself out.
Maybe I just need him to take his helmet off and give me a real emotion, you know?
Right.
Emote to me.
I was still thinking about that article that said the Mandalorian has to take off his helmet. And so now I'm starting to think like maybe that will be like a final moment or like an important episode. It has where he to be. Does yeah,
it's
it.
Gonna have to be like a really. I also like the idea that it's not
scene with them having the helmets on though.
Ooh, whoa! Him and Baby Yoda. Come on, guy. Don't know.
Well, he's gonna definitely have to wear a helmet for that. Oh, you know,
the Force
protection.
With you.
Protection's ooh, baby. Important.
Oh. But there's gonna be a moment where he gets his like head, his helmet like broken or like smashed in.
Yeah,
you see an eyeball or like half a face or like something.
My thought is that helmet is like perfect because it gets shot at and it like not because
that's
a
made
dent.
Out of the good stuff. Yeah,
mm-hmm. It's made out of the good stuff. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So yeah, we'll have to see if it just like he takes it off at a dramatic moment or if it gets knocked
off.
Yeah,
does he have sex with an arm? It's a great question.
That is like, yeah, does he take it off for the business?
It's not even going to be a single sex scene.
It's like how I leave my socks on during sex.
Yeah.
Keep those on. You don't want to see those bad boys.
All three of them. Yeah.
All three of my socks. Oh.
I really like
double up on the right one.
I like the sandcrawler chase. I thought the whole bit was a lot of fun.
They're throwing like trash at him.
Yeah, they're just throwing bits and he's climbing up. He's like getting hit. He's like, "Ow, come on, cut it out!" And they're just like popping out of holes all over the place on this thing.
Yeah, it was a little goofy.
I thought the music here was like too slow. I wanted like more like action music.
I've had some thoughts about the music that I'm not sure.
I'm turning on it. I'm turning on the music.
It's not for me.
I like the theme song up until it gets to its end, and then it switches to a Star Wars song. It goes from like a Western song,
you like Mandalorian's vuvuzelas. That's what I think they are. Like some weird little
vuvuzelas.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't mind those. I don't mind those. But like the ending part where it gets like to a symphony orchestra. Yeah. I'm like, this sucks. Like this is a bad contrast with what you just played.
Uh-huh. This is like the one time where you're right. I definitely feel like the music was almost an afterthought, which is difficult because Star Wars, like the John Williams score is just so ingrained in everything that it's hard to do a Star Wars where you don't have.
They need to do like one or the other. I'd rather them do the spaghetti western type music.
Yeah, and I'm
I think
good
that
with
works
that.
For.
And I think you could still make it like as long as it's big and it's new and dramatic. I think it works just fine in a Star Wars property. Like I don't need it to be the same Star Wars themes you've heard a million times, but it has to be good.
Yeah,
and I feel like it has been lackluster. Like in the first episode, it felt like a lot of temp tracks, and in this episode, it felt like it just wasn't. Trying.
No.
Yeah.
I don't know.
So he...
Which is sad.
Yeah.
Gets knocked off of that Metal Fortress thing.
Mm-hmm. Well, he gets...
The
Jawas
like shock him off.
He gets shot. Yeah.
It's just fun.
This is like...
He reaches the precipice, but falls off anyway.
He spends so much time trying to get up there, and then it's like the simple... Boom. Like, he gets shot like 18 times.
Yeah.
Yeah.
With the zap gun.
Little zap guns.
And falls.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, you done, son.
Mm-hmm.
So he puts his tail between his legs and goes back to the hermit.
Yep.
I should write his name down.
He like kind of mopes a little bit at his ship.
Yeah.
Like, mm-hmm. like here I am.
I mean, think about it. I mean, that's basically his house. I mean, you know, his investment of a couple hundred thousand credits is just broken now.
That's true. Yeah.
Yeah, I don't think he has insurance.
So he doesn't. So he goes to Nick Nolte. We need his name.
It's another 48 hours. Here we go.
Where's Eddie? So he goes to Nick Nolte.
Yeah. He learns that the Jawas would trade back the stuff.
Yeah.
Yes.
If he asked nicely.
Yes.
Yoda eats a frog.
Yes.
Yeah, he does.
That was cute because it was chasing the frog.
It was cute.
Yoda's like to eat weird stuff.
Well, and that Yoda that's was like
it's on brand.
Baby Yoda was giving him some attitude too because the Mandalorian was like, put it down. And Yoda's like, F you, I'm eating this fucking frog, man.
I mean, that frog was like 65% of the way down.
Yeah. Cute little Yoda.
Oh my God, he was so cute.
And then they go to the Jawas to do a little bargain.
And those Jawas were, you know, actually pretty receptive considering
nice.
He zapped five of them.
He killed a lot of their
He killed
their
a
people.
Bunch of their buds.
And why they're still willing to make a deal.
Yeah.
I hated the mode of travel. It was on one of those weird looking reptile things, and he's just sitting on like a
the cart
on a cart.
Uh huh.
Yeah.
I mean, like, obviously, the blurb from the first episode, or whatever it was.
And after they do the deal, which I know I'm skipping over, like, he gets all of his stuff, and they filled up the cart with all the stuff. I was like, they look like they took everything, man. Like, you know, you got jipped. Well,
they took a lot.
Like, he didn't get all of his stuff back, it looked like.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. I see what you're saying.
It was too small.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was looking at that after the fact. There was a lot of the ship still left, because he did get the jump on him a little bit.
Yes.
But yeah. I agree. I agree and justify it in the same, yes, in the same sentence. The Jawas want trade. Mm-hmm. They'll take the Baskar or the gun, or I guess maybe just the Baskar. And yeah, he's like, no, I'm not doing that.
He's like, hell no.
And they're like, oh, we'll take that Yoda then. And then they're like, nah, we're not going to do that either.
Can't have a Yoda, man.
It's like, well, what do you want from us? They want an egg.
Yeah.
Egg.
I felt the whole like bargaining scene was a little weird, because like he shot a flamethrower at their face.
He did.
Like, pretty early on. Like, that's like a
deal breaker.
We're wrapping this up right now. We're out of here.
Right,
and they
didn't
leave. So I was like, and he didn't have any leverage too. He was like, give me the helmet. And they're like, no, I can't do that. They're like, all right, give me the Yoda. No, we can't do that. Something else. All right.
They'll be like, you know, those Jawas are all
business,
man.
I guess they just had a long list of things they wanted.
Yeah. Well, they found one that they wanted.
They did
actually. And they wanted an egg.
Yeah. So there's a place where they lead him, a hole.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And he goes into the hole. It's a wet, slimy, gross hole.
Can I say really quickly?
Uh-huh.
I love the short scene where it cuts to the interior of the ship, and they're just looking out as they're driving, and the one guy turns, and he says, egg! Or whatever he said.
I actually also really liked
it. Was such a goofy scene.
I liked it just because I liked that the cockpit of the Sandcrawler was like, you know, Jawa heights. So like the Mandalorian's like crammed in there. Yeah. He just clearly doesn't fit.
He's like,
I really
liked
that. That was really good.
Ceiling.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
That was like really good, some good world building. Because I would have totally not even thought about it if it had just been normal size and the Jawas are just at small things. And you're like, wait,
yeah,
why
cool
would
that
be?
Was
Jawa size.
That, like, we actually got to get into the Jawas world a little bit.
Yeah, I love the Sandcrawler. That's one of my, like, one of those things. There's, I think, one of the amazing cross sections for the Star Wars books has one. That was one of my favorite.
I think you go inside of it in episode 4 for like a quick second. Doesn't Luke, like, look at some robots and stuff?
You
and then,
see,
like,
you see 3PO and R2 inside it, in like the holding area of other junk droids and stuff.
Okay. Yeah.
And it is short there too, I think, because C-3PO has to like bend over to move around.
So are we assuming this is the same planet then? You think there's Jawas on other planets?
Yeah.
With the same kind of ships?
Yeah.
There's ship and ships?
I think they're like a whole
like
race
trademark,
of
you know?
scavenging people.
Do you
like
think
what they
two
do.
Jawas on separate planets and separate galaxies built the same ship?
Maybe like after what happened in episode 4 when the Empire roasted them all, and they were like, man, screw this planet. Let's move to another planet. And then they go there and this Mandalorian kills a bunch of them. And like, we're having a bad couple of years, you know?
They produce asexually? What's
going
on with
them?
What
if it's not just a car, it's also a spaceship?
Yeah. That's what I'm thinking. Are they like a party bus?
Oh, a party, is that a like party the, space bus?
Is that, maybe I like the idea of there just being that group of Jawas.
Yeah,
guys, I'm going to...
Same ones from episode 4.
I'm gonna go get a. I gotta go do a patent right now. Party space bus. I know I'm like 50 to 60 years ahead.
I'm sure Elon Musk has already patented it.
Oh my god! No, I'm patenting it now.
Oh man.
Just bumping through the galaxy with that disco ball.
Yeah. All right, guys. I don't know how to get back.
Oh.
And so he's required to go get this egg.
Yeah.
So he agrees.
He's like, yeah, whatever, I'll go get it. Go get
it. He doesn't
know
what he's getting into.
Mm-mm. Yep.
He wasn't given any direction.
No.
We get to see some fun... I'm not
Yoda
sure the
comes
word.
With him again.
Oh, yeah. He cruises with him everywhere. That little egg is tied to him somehow,
Yoda.
No?
Yeah.
He needs moral support.
I was just kind of surprised that he wouldn't leave it with the other guy.
Yeah.
Like,
especially
Yoda,
if he's going
to
fight
to
a
come.
Thing. Like, he could
he's
easily
very
get
important.
Smushed.
That's true.
Yeah,
he probably wanted the Yoda close by.
Maybe he didn't know the full danger either.
Yeah. I mean,
he could have assumed.
But. He kind of did, because I think he mentions too, like, he's like, I assume this egg will not be easy to get, because they're asking me to get it for them, and are willing yeah. to trade basically a whole ship for it.
Right.
And he gets the little flashlight on his helmet, which uh-huh. is fun. I was like, accessorizing your armor bits. And we get a cool shot of
an eyeball
rooting around in the cave, and yeah, comes up like upon the thing. He's like, that looks weird. And then, surprise, eyeball.
Yeah, it's like Godzilla.
Mm-hmm.
He like gets flung from the cave.
Yep.
Covered in
well,
mud.
Well, there's like a couple pew 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 pew, yeah. and then he gets flung.
Yeah.
And his chest armor is all busted open.
Oh my god, it's like torn. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And he gets and basically like he's in a muddy pit.
Yep.
And he gets flung.
He gets
into.
So dirty. It made me sad.
Yeah. So like, that meant his gun was like immediately off. Jammed. Couldn't use it because it was gunked up with mud.
Mm-hmm.
I felt scared a little bit here. This felt kind of real, actually, at times.
I wasn't that afraid of the creature. It was a big furry rhinoceros.
I wasn't afraid of the yeah. creature, but he
it wasn't
just
scary
looked,
enough.
He looked like he was
resigned.
Not going to win.
Yeah, he resigned himself at the, I, near
I
the end of that.
I felt bad for him.
Yeah.
I was like, this
I've
is
lost.
Weird.
Yeah. Like, he was like, nope, I lose right now. That's mm-hmm. it. I wasn't high enough level for this quest.
No. He's fighting like a level 3 monster. He's only like level 1 getting
yep.
to level
yep.
2.
Exactly. Yep.
It's hard.
Yep.
Yeah.
He fights it for a little bit. It's just beating him up like
yeah,
nobody's
business.
It's
just throwing
business.
Him around. And
they're just playing with him.
Yep. It's a giant rhinoceros, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
The rhinoceros comes in for the final blow, and then suddenly, it stops, and
yeah.
it's floating, and Yoda's mm-hmm. doing his finger thingies.
Oh, yeah,
little baby Yoda.
He's floating it.
He's like, doing like the X-Wing trick.
Yeah, he can float things. Mm-hmm. And Mandalorian has no clue what's happening.
He's like, what?
It's new to him. He doesn't understand. The Force doesn't really exist to people who haven't seen it, right? And even if you like
so he
hear
was,
rumors of it, you're like, I don't believe that.
Yeah, that's
so
Han Solo
Yoda's got
style,
that
yeah.
mitochondria or whatever it's called.
we don't talk about midichlorians.
He's got
those midichlorians.
He's got some Metamucil.
Yeah.
He needs some Mucinex,
he's got those
too.
Metaphysics going on.
His metatarsals are
yeah.
moving. And
yeah.
He was drinking some
around.
Metabolites out of his
But he's so little and weak, and he probably doesn't really have any strength, and he exhausts himself.
Yeah.
But it gives the Mandalorian enough time to stab the rhinoceros with a little tiny
apparently
leg.
In the most critical spot on
See,
its
this,
body.
This is
okay,
the problem.
Okay, I was also like, he died immediately, and
yeah.
I was like, that would not happen.
Yeah. We're talking
that knife
video
wasn't
game.
Even that long.
We need to see like a weak point on the creature.
Right.
And
give me
be,
a
like,
quick
a
time
growing,
event, you
yeah.
know, where you got... Got a war style where you have to like jump on its back and then right
like,
in the brain.
Or like get like a good like you know crank on that knife. Just don't stab it in. Do a stab.
Yeah,
it in, like,
I mean,
a lift.
Come on, that knife was what? That 6 inches?
It wasn't that, but yeah,
it was like six
small.
Inches. That thing died immediately from a 6-inch stab wound.
Yeah,
I mean
yeah.
that's a serious gash, but and he got him in the neck, but at least he's gonna bleed out.
See, this
right.
is, yeah, this is an issue.
Nope,
and it could have been remedied.
Yeah,
someone could have told him like about the weak points of the thing. When he shot in the back of the steel fortress and like didn't hit anything, could have got corrected.
I mean, you're
like,
right. At least Nick Nolte could have said like, "Hey, FYI, go for the neck."
Yeah, its weak spot is the neck.
Yeah,
yeah, he could have said something like that,
mm-hmm. or like could have had like gills or something that like popped out or. Any sort of indication.
Yeah, well, he sees something on its neck that looks critical. And he's like,
yeah.
maybe
although you
up.
Can argue, I mean, like most creatures, you would probably just go for the neck anyway, right?
Yeah, but
you
the
know,
side
like,
of
instinctly.
This thing is so big.
Well, the side, yeah, I mean, the side of the neck is kind of weird.
Like,
but
if
like,
I stabbed a real rhino in the neck, I would not expect that guy to go down. I'd be like, nah, he's going to just get more mad.
No, right. I mean, he died too fast, but
yeah.
at least like he went for the right area.
Yeah, he cranks on that dagger after it's dead, though. He really
yeah.
gives,
I know,
him
I was
he
like,
gives it a little stir around.
That
yeah, it's already
dead.
It's
dead.
Like, bro, come on.
Just pull that thing out.
Maybe the rhino died of a heart attack at the exact time it got stabbed.
Baby Yoda exploded its heart with the Force.
It could have been.
Oh boy.
Actually, that's a possibility. That could have like weakened it or something like that. Because I mean,
no.
That's always one of those like
right after he let go.
One of those classic Star Wars like dumb questions is like, oh, if you have Force powers, why don't you just give people like Force brain aneurysms all the time?
Darth Vader
like,
chokes people.
Yeah, that's still physical external forces. Just like pop a vessel in the brain. There you go. Just done.
They just haven't gone there yet.
Yeah.
No one's established that precedent.
Maybe by the end of this, Baby Yoda is just going to be exploding heads.
Oh,
give me that.
Scanner style.
Give me crazy, insane Baby Yoda. Give me that. Make him cute.
A dark, also dark side Yoda would be sweet. Oof,
I want it.
There's a lot of heads that explode in the movie Scanners.
I want to see it so bad.
He goes back into the cave, pulls out a hairy egg.
Yeah. It's like hairy. Covered in like a rug.
Oh. Yeah.
It looks like something you get from IKEA.
It's like one of those rope dogs.
It's like a prop you can make, and it's going to be at conventions and stuff. People are going to be walking around with this hairy egg.
Hey, I got the egg. It's covered in mud.
No.
That's gross.
And he gets it back to those
Jawas. When he was like, he was like trying to feel it out to see like how is this going to come out. I was like, this looks gross.
And then too, he was like, is this the egg? Like even it's like, oh, okay.
A shaggy egg. A shag. Yeah. A shag.
Ooh. Oh, well.
A shaggy.
One of those.
Shaggy oof.
I mean, it just looked like wet carpet from the 70s.
The Jawas immediately popped the top of that egg.
Oh, my God.
They go to town.
Dude, they look like Velveeta cheese.
Head Jawa was like, I bring to you my fellow Jawinians.
It must be getting them high. Dude,
he literally just like sliced that right off.
Popped the top right off.
Popped the top, and he was like, everybody eat
they
this.
Just scoop it out, man. They're just scooping it up.
It's crack cocaine, this
egg. Oh, man. Making a mess all over their robes. Yeah. I'm like, don't get yolk
They're
all
really
over
going
yourself.
Pretty nuts
Come
for
on.
It. I would take a taste.
It's an egg, guy.
I would take a taste of it. If they like it that much.
I mean, at least like put your lips to it. It's got like it's like a
or
it's
cook
like
it
a
or something.
It's like
a
cup
clean
in
cut.
A way.
Yeah, it was. Get some bowls. Get some spoons.
Drink out of
Come
it,
on,
yeah.
Guys. Right, you're
wasting
it.
You don't gotta slob it up.
You're wasting it.
The Jawas need some manners.
Yeah.
Yeah. Wow.
Terrible. But they give him his stuff back.
Nick Nolte and the Mandalorian are having a conversation. And Nick Nolte is like, can you describe to me again, like, what happened? Like, can you do it? And the Mandalorian's like, I don't even know.
Yeah.
I don't know what the hell happened, but that's what happened.
That was a great quick scene.
Was it injured? I don't think so. Not physically. Explain it to me again. I still don't understand what happened. Neither do I.
You didn't have to write the actual conversation.
Yeah. The Force isn't out there, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And so Yoda's like knocked out the entire time because
he's in like a Force coma
power.
Still.
So, yeah, he's like a Force coma. Yeah. And and so
his energy bar is at zero.
Yeah, but he's still trucking. He's still trucking in that little shit.
Yeah, he has. Mm-hmm. The egg is still working fine.
It's like a baby Piccolo or something like that.
And we get the training montage of rebuilding the ship.
Which was like, we don't need this.
It wasn't even them rebuilding. It was like Nick Nolte rebuilding the ship and the like Mandalorian just staying there like, cool.
And Yoda still sleeping.
Yeah.
There was like crossfades of Yoda sleeping.
I did like, though, that like the Mandalorian was like, I'm going to have to take this thing to a shop and like, because I don't know what to do here. And Nolte's like, I got this. Don't worry about it.
Yeah, he's like, if you just start working, maybe we could get this
you know,
done
like,
by the morning.
I wonder if you could like supercharge it or like made it better in any way.
Like,
I don't even know.
I was trying to think about too, like if you know, maybe if my car was
That's
in pieces and some guy with metalwork was like, I could fix your car and rebuilt it, I'd be like, all right, I can kind of drive this around. If I had a plane though, and it was in pieces and some dude was like, nah, I can build this in like a night, I'd be like, I'm not gonna fly that plane though. I'm not gonna
though,
do it.
You know what though, but maybe they live in the world where to them the plane situation is similar to your car situation.
I mean, the spaceships in Star Wars are like plug and play.
I guess, but at the same time,
they
like,
maybe
like,
they,
it's
maybe
like
they
Lego
figured out like the
there.
One type of engine that's like, it's okay.
See, it's okay. But if a car, if your engine dies, you're still on the ground. If you're in a, if you're in a ship and you're going up and the engine dies, you just fall back down. Then you're gone. You just go boom.
You do what you got to do.
That's true. I mean, it's his house. He's got to have something, right? You got to get out of there.
Yeah. Yeah.
But he gets it working. And it looks
they fire it up by like the morning, it looks like.
It looked The montage like, made it look like
it was like a week or so.
I'm guessing it was a couple
of days.
Some
time.
Yeah. And that's when
that guy is such a nice character though.
He's really
he really
good.
Cares and he's like.
And I
like
this whole catchphrase of I have spoken. That was good.
Yeah, it's great.
It's so good.
It's really good.
Did you know that person doing the performance artist work, his name is Misty Roses? I looked it up. Guess what else she played? The gorilla in the movie Congo.
Oh my God.
1995. She's had this long career of doing like puppet performance.
That's cool.
That she was really in some commercials like as gorillas and stuff. She was in the Country Bears movie, which was a disaster.
Oh, yeah.
A frightening.
Yeah.
She's got a gorilla and bear career.
Yeah, she's just in costumes.
Was she the gorilla in Trading Places in the cage?
That was before her
time. No, that was Jim Belushi.
Yeah.
But she does a great job.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah, no, it's nice.
Great performance.
Some of the mouth work doesn't...
It may not be totally match up. I don't know if she's doing that or not. But.
Right, yeah.
And I thought it was good enough. I mean, it was...
That's probably not on her.
It was live-action Ninja Turtles movie good, and that is, like, some impressive puppet work anyway. Like, I don't... And because it's real, I don't... And, like,
he's never been in CG that I could tell. Maybe when he's, like, on top of the blur and a wide
like,
shot.
Like, it looked good.
I mean, I love the fact that this is a real person.
Yep.
I mean, we're literally saying, like, there's three people that are kind of playing this part, I bet.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
You know, a mouth, the actual actor, and maybe someone moving the mouth. But they could have just done a CG character, and they didn't do that. And it's better for that reason.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Amy, want green drop drink?
Oh, Congo.
You guys not see Congo?
No, I know you're making a Congo reference.
It's been a long time on that one.
I still remember the How Did This Get Made about that. That one's classic.
And then he just flies away, he's contemplating whether or not to give up the Yoda.
Yeah.
Okay, you were talking about missed opportunities. Yeah. This was my missed opportunity. Where Yoda wakes up and heals his arm. Right? Right? He could have healed his arm, like, right there.
He could have healed the Mandalorian's arm or his own arm?
No, the Mandalorian's arm. You remember that little cut that he was trying to heal at the beginning?
Yeah, didn't he end up healing it? Didn't he end up covering it up and it being fine?
I mean, the Mandalorian did that. He had the crazy, like, burning tool, whatever that he was doing.
Yeah, I mean, he was trying to do it. I think he kind of gave up on it, but, like,
maybe
this could have been an opportunity for him to heal that. You guys don't sound on board with that.
Not that one, particularly. No.
What?
Okay,
whatever.
When they were fixing the ship, there was the bit of him fixing his chest armor, and I was confused because it seemed like it was pretty clear he was fixing, like, electronics inside the chest armor?
I kind of thought he was half robot or part robot.
I was like, what is that? What's in his chest stuff that has,
like, there's
to
definitely
get
blood.
Batteries and fixed and stuff? I don't know.
In episode one, it looked like his shoulder was, like, robotic in some way.
Yeah. So, yeah. I'm curious to know now that, like, you know, so in the first one, he got shot in the shoulder, gets new shoulder. And this one rips off the chest. Is he going to fly back and get a new chest plate now?
I don't know.
What's going to happen? I'm excited. I hope maybe. So. But at the same time, does that mean he has to turn in Baby Yoda? He can't turn in Baby Yoda.
No, he's going to get wrapped up in another adventure.
That's his life, though. Just, he's gotta, it's just another job,
he's
Andy.
Really, he's going to want to know what they're going to do with Baby Yoda.
Yeah, he's got to turn him in, get the reward, and then have his second thoughts, and then go save him. Yeah. That's what it's got to be. He's going to get his new armor and go out and save him.
Which is what happens in Lone Wolf and Cub, which this is based off of.
That's right.
I was watching earlier.
I have not watched that yet, but I want to.
Yeah. I still don't remember what that is.
It's a Japanese film.
You just talked about that.
In the 60s or 70s. About a wandering samurai who, like, saves a child from being murdered and has to, like, he gets, like, framed for all this other stuff. It's a big, like, complicated story, but he's just, like, this badass samurai who has to take care of a kid.
That's on Plex?
Yeah.
Damn it. I need to watch this. Damn it.
It has, like, one of the best opening scenes I've seen in a movie in I don't even know how long.
Mm. All right, let's wrap this up.
Let's go see it, yeah.
Like, he never had responsibility before. He's just been this hired gun. And now all of a sudden he has to take care of a kid? That's not in the job description. What's the Mandalorian going to do?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. So this is the same thing. I see. I see.
So if you want spoilers for the rest of the Mandalorian, just go watch the movie.
Oh, no. I'm going to do it, though. I'm going to do it.
Yeah, probably.
I'm okay.
I'm fine with it. Yeah, I mean, it's good. It's a good story.
There's a lot of fun, like, backstabby bits that are going to be definitely show their ugly head in this one, too, but... Let's get that crew together.
Yeah. That's what I want. Give me some of that crew action.
They started.
They keep showing photos of Carla Gugino.
Yes.
They haven't announced what her character is yet, but she keeps on showing up in the preview before
Bill Burr. Bill Burr, he's coming up. I saw a photo of him.
Mm-hmm.
Didn't even look like him, though. Looked like William Burr.
Looked like Aaron Burr. Yeah, it should be good. I'm excited for the rest of the season.
There's more to come.
It's slower and it's emptier, but at the same time, it's a space western. So I think
it's the first season. It'll pick up.
It's supposed to be. Yeah.
I wish they just add.
They probably don't have a lot of money to throw at this right now.
Just tease me a little bit. You know.
Wait.
A little bit.
They don't have a lot of money.
It's Disney. It's $12 million.
They have all the money.
I'm saying. Well, no, I get that. I'm saying that they started a huge project and they're funding a lot of different projects at the same time. So I'm sure they had to divvy it up in a responsible way.
I get it.
Netflix isn't in a huge amount of debt. They're fine. Streaming services are a proven model of making money.
You guys hear there's rumors that Netflix is courting Nickelodeon for a partnership.
Yeah, I heard that.
Yeah. I was like, that could work. Give me.
They've already teased them a little bit.
Freaking give me
New Rocko's Modern Life.
Give me my guts. Give me my Double Dares on there. I'm gonna watch all of those. They'll old be new shows. Too. Oh my They'll be gosh. New yes. versions of those shows. Give me all that stuff. I want new Global Guts. Give me some new stuff.
You're more of a Kirk fan, pretty hard though.
I That's true. Say. Yeah. I just call her Mo, but it's yeah.
You know. And let's see what happens with
them. In chapter three, the baby colon part two.
They haven't released the titles of episodes because I feel like they're spoilery.
Yeah, that's probably true. Yeah.
So they're just waiting.
Yeah.
That's okay. I'm not watching anything.
Yeah.
I didn't even know when it came out.
Fridays.
Yeah.
Except for sometimes it'll be like on a Wednesday. What? And then it'll be like
on a Thursday. Sometimes it'll be on the other. And sometimes it's going to be on a Monday. And then sometimes it'll be on a Tuesday.
Yeah. Wow.
And then sometimes...
sometimes it'll be on a usually, day that doesn't usually, even exist
usually
yet.
Friday, and the last two episodes like come out in a weird schedule.
Yeah.
All right. They're trying to just like rush so this out
Is this series ending before the new movie?
Yeah, it comes out after. The last episode is the Friday after Christmas, 27th.
Mm. Okay, so that's probably... Yeah, they're trying to coincide this with that leading up to the release, which makes sense.
They are. Mm-hmm. They are. We're going to see it.
Oh, hell.
We're all going to see it.